What is going on, fellow adventurers? Today, we have a very special video for you guys. We're gonna be doing something that is actually one of my favorite ways to fish. It is something that I've been doing long before I had my fishing YouTube channel here in Hudson's Fishing Adventures. Today, we are gonna be fishing Lake LBJ under some docks in my Pelican mini boat. So if you guys don't know what this is, which I mean, obviously you don't, I've never showed this on my channel until today. This is my Pelican mini boat. It is about a 10-foot awesome boat. It is a plastic boat, yes indeed, but I promise you guys, it is about the best little fishing boat imaginable. It is like ideal. We're coming up, there's a little bass right there, you guys. We were putting in at the LBJ Marina. There's some little bass right here. What a beautiful day. No wind, high wind is 2 miles an hour, you guys. And right here, I have my Minkota trolling motor. It's a 50-pound thrust. We got it powered off 12-volt battery. We got the Humminbird depth finder ready to go. It's gonna be me and my dad today. I'm pumped. Okay, y'all, we are heading to our favorite cove. It is a cove that will not be named for legal reasons, AKA, it's my secret fishing spot here on LBJ, but we're heading across. I wanna do some trolling, but before we do that, I've got my Humminbird Fishing Buddy Max depth finder. We're gonna get this guy set up. I have it on sonar right now, I believe. Yep. And this thing just kind of locks in here. Yep, it's on sonar. That way we get a good view. I'm not sure. I'll get a little bit closer so y'all see. 17 feet. Okay, guys, we're heading into our secret cove. We got our ultralight rods with some little jig heads. And we're about to go ahead and put on the crappie jigs before we get into our cove via this plastic boat. While it is awesome, and it definitely has some advantages, it is pretty loud. Just makes a lot of ruckus, so we're gonna go ahead and get everything on before we get down there. And we are both gonna start off, right, Dad, I believe, with the classic Crappie Max Cajun Critter Pumpkin Little Jig. This guy's a classic. It caught my two personal best bass ago, actually. I caught about a 3.5-pound largemouth bass on this. And we've caught just countless brim and bass and even catfish on these things, actually. So they're classic, can't beat them. I wouldn't cast your thing. I got the classic in deep water. I know it wasn't grass and I didn't have any grass on. Oh, there he is. You guys, first fish of the day.
You came off?
Yep. You guys, beautiful long eater to start off the day. That was pretty quick. There you go, buddy. We are not keeping fish today. Oh, got him, bass. Oh, you see that? It's the same looking one I knew was a bass. Got him. Got him, you guys. Oh my God, talk about a big bluegill. You guys, we gotta be as quiet as you can. I think we're filming it. Yeah, we're wrong. What a bluegill. I know that there's more in there. Beautiful fish. First one to catch him wins. Got him. Oh, he's hit it every time so far. Same spot too, right at the back of that slip. Got him. God, it's a good fish. Oh my God, look at the size of this bluegill. No way, Dad. No way, you're not gonna believe this. You're not gonna believe the size of this bluegill. Guys, look at the size of this bluegill I just pulled out. You gotta be as quiet as you can. The inside of me wants to scream as loud as I can, but we gotta be quiet. Look at the, not only size, but beauty and color. That is a full-on purple bluegill. Bigger than my hand.
turn wrong? Left your heart torn? Is that what devils do? Took you so long, where only fools go. I shook the angel and young. Now I'm rising from the crowd, rising up to you. Filled with all the strength I find, there's nothing I can't do.
Got him.
You got him? Is that a fish? Oh man, that's the ultimate mini bass.
Oh.
I'm gone.
So, I have my aerator.
Do you?
Yeah, I shouldn't keep him though.
I just got hit.
You guys, it is so hard for me to release this guy and not keep him as a little pet. Tell me that that isn't the cutest little bass you've ever seen. Comment down below if you guys want me to make a video where I catch some of these guys and keep them as pets in either my ponds, my aquariums, anything like that. There you go, buddy. Makes sense why something was hitting it really hard and it's so aggressive, but we couldn't catch him.
That's a big old moccasin.
You guys, look at that snake skin.
Oh, man.
That's probably 4 feet, maybe five. Probably 4.5 feet. No. Maybe I can jig.
You want me to take that?
Oh, got him, got him, got him. Oh. Oh my God, big bass. Don't move.
Oh man.
You guys. Oh my God, did you see that? You guys, about a 4 or 5 pound bass just came and was chasing a big, big bluegill. It wasn't like a tiny fish, about a maybe 4 or 5 inch bluegill in the shell. I really hope the camera picked that up. I mean, we actually heard it before we saw it. Was that him?
No, but I knew it was a fish.
You guys, we're about to try and go in the Pelican mini boat under that bridge into the official no man's land, fishing on the way. Oh, whoa, smoked right there. Okay, you guys, all the rods are down low. We got the trolling motor low. Me and my dad are crouching down with our seats folded, and we're gonna try and go under this bridge.
This is a place only a mini boat can go.
We made it, you guys. Now the only thing we can do. Man, it hit that hard.
Oh yeah, at least a good one. Oh yeah.
Whoa.
Oh yeah.
Oh my God, big bass. It's a bass. It's a big bass.
I told you.
I got the net.
I told you. Oh, big fish. Big fish, huh? This is when you say big fish. And I got a dry fish.
Oh, you guys. You guys. My dad just smoked that bass. That's heavy too. Oh, there we go, you guys. What a beautiful bass my dad just caught. Healthy largemouth. What's that?
Go ahead.
Let's get him released.
Oh my God, a big fish, Hudson. Oh, I saw his mouth open. Oh.
Was it him?
Yeah. Well, I don't know if it's him, but it was just a big, big, big bass. So stay right here and fish for a minute. Straight ahead.
Oh, got hit. Wait, don't get hit. Yep. Bunch of bluegill.
Yeah, straight ahead, side on, way down in
there. That was a bunch of fishing line.
The line I retrieved.
That's right where I want to throw, though. Oh, look at this build. Oh, big bass, big bass. Oh my gosh!
Alright, fish again.
No.
That's alright. I saw him bust in the water. You had him.
It's a good bass, you guys. Oh, There we go, you guys. That is how you do a successful LBJ launch, fish, and exit. What an awesome day. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, I would love it if you'd smash that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell. It was so much fun, not only filming, riding the mini boat, but also fishing in LBJ. It was a blast. And we really caught the heck out of some big brim and even some bass. If you guys did enjoy watching us fish in this Pelican boat, make sure you drop a like down below, and I would love to get out fishing this guy more. If you guys want to check out this Pelican boat for yourself, I will have it linked down in the description below. And one more thing I want to show you all before we end this video is you will see my nice collection of stickers. About 90% of them are fishing, and some are totally not related to fishing, like my Scoop Street sticker. But man, if you live in the South Texas area, I don't care if you're out of state, you need to come into Texas to have some Scoop Street ice cream. It is the best thing to have after you go fishing. I'll have a link down in the description below. And then also a big thanks to Zi'don Smith Fishing. He sent me an awesome pack of lures, actually three of them, and this awesome sticker that I now have added onto my sticker collection on the Pelican mini boat. And we actually are gonna be doing a video soon with those lures that he sent me. I won the giveaway, so I'm going to be doing a little fishing slam with those. I hope y'all enjoy this video once more. Thank you guys so much for watching. Every view, every like, every subscription means so, so much to me. You guys are what are making my dream of being a professional fisherman and YouTuber becoming possible. So thank you so much. I will catch y'all on the next fishing adventure.